The following is one of a five-part series from footage shot at Okayasu Kozai, a knife supply shop in Tokyo, Japan, during our 2010 Carter Cutlery Japan tour. Kazuo Okayasu has been a main player in the history of the Japanese Knifemakers Guild.
Mr. Okayasu, can you tell us about the state of custom knives in Japan in the last 25 years? Because it's changed. It used to be popular. Now it's not so popular. Can you tell us about the history of 25 years of knife making in Japan?
That time is 1978. Yeah, 1978. It's my friend, Mr. Sakane. He is the first chairman of JKG.
Japanese Knife Makers Guild.
Yes. And he said that the United States has a very nice knife show. And we check everything. So that's, that time is 1978, Kansas City.
Kansas City.
Yes, Kansas City knife show and Crown Center Hotel. So we check and everything. Then, we are bring to the Japanese style knife, bring to the United States. So I checked and cheap ticket, you know.
For everyone to
yeah,
know.
Then my friend is Mr. Inoue, and Kikuhide Cutlery is boss.
Inoue-san.
Inoue-sensei? Inoue-san, it's, Inoue-san is, he is Kikuhide Cutlery.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Kikuhide Cutlery is owner.
Okay.
And he and me and Mr. Nakagawa, he already died, but he is a sheath maker. Knife sheath maker. And Shirataka is a very famous, now it's he makes the Yakushi temple of what's the nail? Kugi.
Oh, sure. Yeah, the temple nails, special temple nails. Yeah, okay.
The watashi desho, me and Mr. Inoue, Kikuhide Cutlery, and Mr. Sakane, Mr. Nakagawa, he is a sheath maker, and also. Shirataka is he's a this maker.
Yes.
And Mr. Furukawa, Shiro Furukawa.
He's I know Mr. Yeah, Shiro. You know, yeah, he's one of the most famous.
Yes, of course.
In all of Japan.
Yeah. Then he and anyway, the five people
went to Kansas
went
City.
Together. Yes, Kansas City. And firstly, we bring to the some almost 100 piece of knife, and of course a carpenter knife and handmade knife and everything I bring to the suitcase. So the firstly, you know, our aircraft is fly to Honolulu, Hawaii, and the check baggage, you know.
Yes.
The America also United States, so please open the this suitcase.
Yes, it comes.
So many knives, you know.
Yes,
What it is? You were prior to the sightseeing, but you bring to the something you
for business.
Yes. Then like you said that it's true.
Okay.
Then that baggage almost fixed in the custom in Hawaii.
Oh, got stopped.
Yeah,
stopped
in custom.
Oh,
then I go to the Los Angeles and Hilton Hotel.
Yes.
Downtown Hilton Hotel, we stay. How to get the
luggage?
Yeah,
you probably had to get a customs broker.
Yeah, custom. We talk to the custom broker.
Yes.
But many people all together thinking about. But I speak only English.
Oh, you're the only one.
Some other guy is not speak. Oh, he listening okay.
Yeah.
But he speaking okay. But he very shy. You know.
Sure.
And the Japanese people and everybody is speaking not so. You know,
that's a good thing you're not shy.
Yeah, I talk to the anyway the custom and the custom broker and I pay a tax and bring back to the my suitcase.
Yes.
And next day we fly to Kansas City. And everybody. Oh.
So you made it in time for the show.
Yeah. Okay. Just and we a table.
Yes.
Fixed green and fixed the price and everything.
Yes.
And open the show, no sale.
Oh, no sales.
Yeah, because this one is not American people understand. This is carpenter tools, but there no handle, no sheath. No, kiridashi is not knife. That's a tool. Okay, I understand. So. But Shiro Furukawa's Furukawa-san knife is sold.
His own.
Yeah.
American style.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and very cleanly
and,
done. Very
yeah, he made after the Gaba Sakai and he and contact and his knife is Kansas City Memorial Knife.
Mm-hmm.
And that knife is very, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
Before how to make the knife, it, his teacher is Bob Loveless.
Oh, Bob Loveless.
Yes,
sure,
Loveless.
Sure.
He's he already
just
died.
Passed away just a couple of months ago.
Yeah, September 2nd.
Mm-hmm.
2nd of September.
Uh-huh.
And he had lung cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And he died.
I think he was 81 years old.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So anyway, the that time is firstly in the Shiro Furukawa's knife is sold.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, everybody! Oh, very, very jealous.
You thought that was you thought that was a good thing.
Yeah, but
and you wanted to repeat the success.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
yeah. So that is the first Japanese, all Japanese, and the first time in the United States custom knife show,
mm-hmm.
1978 October,
mm-hmm.
very hot day. Muggy, yeah, very muggy day, you know that, and but a very nice Coors beer. Coors and Budweiser is very nice, you know. Yeah, and then also the that Texas beer, it's very funny, you know, Texas roaster beer, and everybody in the, drink beer. like a shake pinkan and a shake drink.
like a milkshake?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's a bottle, you know.
Yeah, the bottle,
in
yeah.
Japan, it's like a glass.
Oh, you pour.
Yeah.
You pour in Japan.
Yeah, but
in America, they drink straight from the bottle.
Yeah. And also the kanpai like this, kankan,
yeah.
drink.
Okay, let's get back on the knives.
Yeah.
So,
anyway,
so then you
yeah.
started the JKG because
JKG,
of that success.
So after... Before, we are back from that show, back Kansas City Knife Show, and we are back from United States to Japan,
mm-hmm.
and we are talking about this class.
Mm-hmm.
And it started Knife Tomo no Kai, firstly, the friendship knife.
Like a knife association.
Association, like
yeah.
That, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The first started the knife association. The, about that time it's about 40 people as a member. 43.
Yeah, okay.
Around 40.
They joined this
yes.
association.
And at that time it's Mr. Aida-san and
Major
yeah,
Aida, yeah.
Aida
mm-hmm.
and Shiro Furukawa
mm-hmm.
and so many knife maker. But they not really understand what is a custom knife.
Okay.
So the everybody that learned to the book
mm-hmm.
or some Bob Loveless.
So you kind of scramble
yeah.
to catch up to the West
mm-hmm.
to learn about what custom
what,
knives
what
are all
is
about.
It? Yeah,
how
what
to
is
make
it?
Them.
Yeah.
How to sell them.
Yeah.
How to market them.
Yeah.
Sure.
Then of course the no steel. You know the only steel flat bar is 440C. That's it.
440 stainless.
Yes.
In order to grind the knives out.
Yeah.
That was the only thing available.
Yeah. That's an it's a flat bar.
Flat bar.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And after the 5 years, 1983 or around that time, is Bob Loveless come from United States, Riverside.
Mm-hmm.
California.
And,
then,
and he was a big teacher.
Yeah, that's right. And
he generously taught everybody.
Right. And he stayed here, Shinjuku Hotel. Shinjuku Hilton or Sheraton. I forget about the hotel. He stayed. Hey, Kato-san, please come to my hotel room. Room number is okay.
Mm-hmm.
I went to his room.
Mm-hmm.
And he bring a whiskey at the bar.
Yes.
Maker's Max.
Yeah.
And he and me and the grass and Oksan and the shopping outside.
His wife went shopping.
Yeah,
just the two men.
Yeah, two
and
men.
And whiskey.
Yeah. And Maker's Max, man.
Yeah.
Maker's Max.
I think it became Empty Mark.
Oh, yeah. Empty Mark.
Did it become? You started with Maker's Mark.
Oh yeah.
But then it was Empty.
Oh
empty
yeah,
mark.
That's right. And, Bob Loveless said, Kazuo, you are Japanese. Japan is a very nice industry. Everything Japan is, you know, the we are fighting World War II. That time is you make Yamato or some of course a big weapon or something, and you are very clever people. So you know that steel technology, right? Then we are chemical composition. 例えばカーボンが何パーセント、カーボン is 1.2 and chromium is 0.8 or molybdenum is 0.6 or something else.
So you're very and knowledgeable about the metallurgy.
Yes, he understands.
Oh, he understands too.
Yes.
So you guys were talking.
Yes, but I understand. Of course, I'm my father is like a metallurgy.
Yeah, metallurgist.
Yeah, metallurgist. Mm-hmm. So the, my grandfather is a salt business, and he and easy to this is a grinding spark fire. He know that. Oh, this is carbon is 1.2, and this is
oh, just from the spark.
Yeah, sparking.
Yeah, just from
and
the spark.
And we are sparking test around. I stay in Hitachi Metal at 1 week in the training.
Oh wow!
What is
in Yasuki
high carbon?
Perfection.
Yes, So the. Well, and then talking about 3 hours, 4 hours, now, talking and Bob Loveless for the custom knife steel, what is the best? And that time is he using it, his steel is 154 cm. Which it's is a crucible company.
Crucible company.
Yeah, crucible company is 154 cm. Steel. Then I bought from United States and bring to Hitachi Metal. And one guy, Hitachi Metal laboratory's man said, laboratory's man had said, Okayasu, no problem. We have already this metal, same metal. And 154 cm is mean 15 chrome.
15% chromium?
Oh, yes, and 4 molybdenum.
Not 15%. Is it 15%?
Yeah, 15%.
Okay. And 15%
four molybdenum.
Yes.
And vacuum melting. That is 154 cm steel. What it mean? And I understand. So that time is that we are Hitachi Metal already making ATS-34. And ATS-34 is for the Shinkansen or space shuttle or something. And,
oh really? Had lots of special applications.
Yeah,
already.
That's right. And F1 and
F1 race car driving.
Car or, anyway, speed, high speed or high temperature or very stress and anyway, the tough steel.
High performance.
Yeah, and they are looking for the very tough steel. And also, we are tough edge.
Good
looking,
edge.
Yeah, good edge.
Good edge retention.
Yeah, that's right. It's long time. It's keep cutting. And Bob Loveless knife is sent to Buster Warenski. And Buster Warenski.
Yep.
And Buster Warenski enjoys hunting.
Yes.
And one knife is no sharpening. It's four deer.
Oh, they can skin and dress out four deer.
Out four
without resharpening.
No sharpening.
Okay, so that's what
Loveless dropped.
Big surprise.
Yeah.
That was a big surprise at that time.
And at that time, it's Rita from Buster Warenski to Loveless. Thank you. Very nice knife. Thank you very much. I enjoyed the hunting. And then that's Rita and the knife. Some dealer delivered to my company.
Oh, okay.
Mr. Okayasu, this is my Loveless. Please buy this knife and this letter. Of course, this one is Buster Warenski.
That's a famous one.
Yeah, he's a very famous knife maker. And also, Bob Loveless make knife. But something, of course, I'm used second hand. But I'm very interested in that knife. As I pay about $2,000
at that time. At that time, which was a lot of money.
Yeah, that's
right. Especially for...
400,000 in Japan. 400,000 yen in 2000.
Oh, in
$2,000. It's about dollar is 200.
Oh, okay.
Now 83.
Yeah. What happened?
Yeah. So the I anyway the I'm visit to 1 year and 3-4 time visit to United States or any other country. And sometimes visit to my shop and please tell me, teach me. how to the knife business. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's from Korea, from Taiwan, and also from China. And many foreign country people visit my company and shop. Mm-hmm. And I deliver it to some steel and how to make knife technology or some handle material. Of course, that one is a bring from United States for Stag. Now it's very, Stag is very hard to get. Mm-hmm. You know?